Good morning, St. Martins. Today's Mass will be celebrated in loving memory of Miss Alvina Cuellar, in loving memory of Irma Elizabeth Young, in loving memory of Wally Moon, father and grandfather, in loving memory of Wilson Requena, and repose of the soul of Albina Alcocer, and repose of the soul of Harrison Smith, and thanksgiving for Mr. and Mrs. Renee Cardona, and in thanksgiving to the miraculous infant of Prague and St. Anthony by Georgia Wagner. Well, sisters and brothers, as we always begin, we begin in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with each one of you.
And with your spirit.
In order to prepare ourselves for these sacred mysteries, we should recognize those moments in our week, in our day, when we fail in not loving as Jesus has called us to love, asking for his pardon, asking for his mercy, asking for our conversion. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Oh,
Let us pray. Keep your family safe, O Lord, with unfailing care, that relying solely on the hope of heavenly grace, they may be defended always by your protection. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. In the year King Uzziah died, I saw the Lord seated on a high and lofty throne, with the train of his garment filling the temple. Seraphim were stationed above. They cried one to the other, "Holy, holy, holy is the Lord of hosts. All the earth is filled with his glory." At the sound of that cry, the frame of the door shook and the house was filled with smoke. Then I said, "Woe is me, I am doomed, for I am a man of unclean lips, living among a people of unclean lips. Yet my eyes have seen the King, the Lord of hosts." Then one of the seraphim flew to me, holding an ember that he had taken with thongs from the altar. He touched my mouth with it and said, "See, now that this has touched your lips, your wickedness is removed, your sin purged." Then I heard the voice of the Lord saying, "Whom shall I send? Who will go for us?" "Here I am," I said, "send me." The word of the Lord. The responsorial psalm. In the sight of the angels, I will sing your praises, Lord. In the sight of the angels, I will sing your praises, Lord. I will give thanks to you, O Lord, with all my heart, for you have heard the words of my mouth. In the presence of the angels, I will sing your praise. I will worship at your holy temple and give thanks to your name. In the sight of the angels, I will sing your praises, Lord. Because of your kindness and your truth, for you have made great above all things your name and your promise. When I called, you answered me. You built up strength within me. In the sight of the angels, I will sing your praises, Lord. All the kings of the earth shall give thanks to you, O Lord, when they hear the words of your mouth. And they shall sing of the ways of the Lord. Great is the glory of the Lord. In the sight of the angels, I will sing your praises, Lord. Your right hand saves me. The Lord will complete what he has done for me. Your kindness, O Lord, endures forever. Forsake not the work of your hands. In the sight of the angels, I will sing your praises, Lord.
A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, I hand unto you as of first importance what I also received, that Christ died for our sins in accordance with the Scriptures, that he was buried, that he was raised on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures, that he appeared to Cephas, then to the 12. After that, he appeared to more than 500 brothers at once, most of whom are still living, though some have fallen asleep. After that, he appeared to James, then to all the apostles. Last of all, as to one abnormally born, he appeared to me. Therefore, whether it be I or they, so we preach, and so you believed. The word of the Lord.
Thank you.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A proclamation from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. While the crowd was pressing in on Jesus and listening to the word of God, he was standing by the lake of Gennesaret. He saw two boats there along by the lake. The fishermen had disembarked and were washing their nets. Getting into one of the boats, the one belonging to Simon, he asked him to put out a short distance from the shore. Then he sat down and taught the crowd from the boat. After he had finished speaking, he said to Simon, "Put into deep water and lower your nets for a catch." Simon said in reply, "Master, we have worked hard all night and have caught nothing, but at your command I will lower the nets." When they had done this, they caught a real number of fish, and their nets were tearing. They signaled to their partners in the other boat to come to help them. They came and filled both boats, so that the boats were in danger of sinking. When Simon Peter saw this, he fell at the knees of Jesus and said, "Depart from me, Lord, for I am a sinful man." For astonishment at the catch of fish they had made seized him, and all those with him, and likewise James and John, the sons of Zebedee, who were partners of Simon. Jesus said to Simon, "Do not be afraid. From now on you will be catching men." When they brought their boats to the shore, they left everything and followed him. Sisters and brothers, this is the gospel of the Lord. Are you willing to go out into the deep? Are you willing to go out into the deep? Simon, Peter, and his group of friends, fellow fishermen, have come back from a night of fishing. And when they arrive, somebody is present to them. Somebody who asks them to actually use their boat to sit and preach the word of God. Listening to the word of God will change you. Do you want to go out into the deep? During these past couple of weeks, I've had a number of couples stop by the parish to begin the process of marriage preparation. And as I pray with them, this question of, do you want to go out into the deep, is a question that I ponder and hope that they are listening to. And it's a question not just for future married couples, but for you and I, and maybe for some young men who may be called to religious life or to the priesthood. Jesus is calling, go out into the deep waters. There's a wonderful social worker by the name of Brené Brown who speaks to us about vulnerability. And she speaks of vulnerability as being the core, the heart of human experience. And as I listen to Jesus calling Peter out into the deeper water, I hear Jesus inviting me to open myself up in a way that can make me vulnerable. Because if we heard the gospel, we hear a reluctance, a hesitation from Peter, who again has come back empty-handed from a night of fishing. And this stranger, who began to preach and he listened to, is asking him to go out into the deep. and he listens. Peter is you and I. He is calling us to go into the deep and to open our hearts, to be vulnerable, to show up, to let people know who we are. And the moment when we are able to open ourselves up to let people know who we are allowing Jesus to be present to us. Because as you recall, Peter did not go out on that first fishing expedition with him. Now he is. And he goes out into the deep waters and is willing to take a risk. Is willing to take a risk of coming back without any fish. But this time around, he is filled with abundance of God's grace, seen in the number of fish that are caught. In our lives, Jesus is inviting us to go into the deep, to open our hearts and to be vulnerable, to allow ourselves to be seen by others. And there's a beautiful sense of honesty in Peter's response of saying to Jesus, "Depart from me, I am a sinner." And that, brothers and sisters, is all of our responses. We are all sinners, yet called by God. Be not afraid is the question, or I'm sorry, the statement that Jesus tells Peter. And it's a statement that needs to stay with us, not to be afraid to go out into those deep waters, to open our hearts, to let people see us, to be known. Because when we're able to do that, we're able to allow Jesus to be present within ourselves and within others. So let's go out into the deep. Let's listen to those invitations that God has for us, for transformation, for change, and to let go of everything that we have and to follow him. Amen. So let us pray. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried and rose again on the third day in accordance with the scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
That in our parishes, worship, and ministries, we may proclaim the gospel of the risen Christ. Let us pray to the Lord that all who serve the church as pastors, ministers, and teachers may faithfully carry on the apostles' work of building up the body of Christ. Let us pray to the Lord that all churches and faith communities may be partners in catching souls in a net of God's love and forgiveness. Let us pray to the Lord that the nations and peoples of the world may sing together a song of peace and thanksgiving to the Creator of all. Let us pray to the Lord that those who are separated and estranged from the love of God and love of family and friends may be restored, like Paul, to communion with God and community with us. Let us pray to the Lord that all who have died in the peace of Christ may sing the praises of the Lord in the presence of the angels forever. Let us pray to the Lord that God will hear the prayers we now make in the silence of our hearts.
Lord, hear our prayers. Lord God, you have heard our prayers. Help us to have the courage to go out into the deep, to open our hearts, to allow ourselves to be seen. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Pray, sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. O Lord, our God, who once established these created things to sustain us in our frailty, grant, we pray, that they may become for us now the sacrament of eternal life, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For in goodness you created man, and when he was justly condemned, in mercy you redeemed him through Christ our Lord. Through him, the angels praise your majesty. Dominions adore and powers tremble before you. Heaven and the virtues of heaven and the blessed seraphim worship together with exaltation. May our voices, we pray, join with theirs in humble praise as we acclaim. Holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. And giving you thanks, he said the blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of our faith. Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son, and filled with the Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with Saint Martin and with Saint Ignatius, and with all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Lawrence, our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassionate, merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. And to our departed sisters and brothers, and to all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory. Through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Filled with great joy in knowing that we are sons and daughters of God, we pray the prayer that Jesus taught us. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with each one of you. Let us offer each other a sign of peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb. May the body and blood of Christ keep us all safe for eternal life. Amen.
Señor.
soul of Christ, body of Christ,
blood of Christ, inebriate me.
Water from the side of Christ, wash me. Passion of Christ, strengthen me. O good Jesus, hear me. Within thy wounds, hide me. Permit me not to be separated from thee. From the foe, defend me. At the hour of my death, call me. Let me come to thee. And may the saints of me praise you forever and ever. Amen. Let us pray. O God, who have willed that we be partakers in the one bread and the one chalice, grant us, we pray, so to live that, made one in Christ, we may joyfully hear fruit for the salvation of the world, through Christ our Lord. Amen. Got a couple of announcements for you here. It's the first Sunday of the month, so we're going to do some birthday and anniversary blessings right after I finish with the other announcements. St. Vincent de Paul. Last week we had our fifth Sunday special collection at St. Vincent de Paul, but the bank information on the screen was incorrect. We apologize for that. What you'll be seeing right now is correct. It's Belize Bank Corp. Limited. And right now you can take a screenshot and get the info you wish to donate by account transfer, or you can come to the parish to make your donation. On February 16th, we have a web talk. And this talk will be on the Sacrament of Confirmation. What else? Just a reminder for everybody that the church is open in person Monday through Friday for the 6:30 Mass in the morning. And pay attention to our website. We're hoping to be open on our Sunday celebrations soon. So just keep your eyes open for that. Okay, so we've got our blessings for birthdays and anniversaries. So I'll ask you to bow your heads for God's blessing. God of all creation, we offer you grateful praise for the gift of life. Hear the prayers of your servant, who call today the day of their births and rejoices in your gifts of life and love, family and friends. Bless them with your presence and surround them with your love, that they may grow in wisdom, knowledge, and grace, enjoy many happy years, all of them pleasing to you. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Amen. And for those anniversaries, bow your heads once again. Lord God and Creator, we bless and praise your name. In the beginning, you made man and woman so that they might enter a communion of life and love. You likewise bless all who are celebrating anniversaries. Look with kindness on them today. Amid the joys and struggles of their life, you have preserved the union between them. Renew their marriage covenant. Increase your love in them and strengthen their bond of peace so that they may always rejoice in the gift of your blessing. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace.